Hello everyone, my name is Ishmael and welcome to today's video. And in today's video, I want to talk about to you about something called the promised land, okay? Allow me to tell you that everybody in this world, you have a promised land. As long as you are born again Christian, even before you became born again Christian, the Lord had already planned that He's going to do something great in your life. He knows the plans that He has for you. He has planned something great, never think otherwise. So there is a thing called the promised land. The Lord is planning something great about your life, something major, something amazing. So allow me to tell you more about the promised land, and that now somebody is entering the promised land. And that is what the Lord has promised you from the beginning of the year. And this is high time you see the fulfillment. Allow me to tell you that never look at yourself as if like God has nothing great about your life. You look down on yourself. You have the promised land. That's why God Almighty wants you to be a born again Christian, and He promises to bless you. He promises to do amazing things in your life because you have the promised land to reach to. And to the promised land, you have to travel, just like how He called Abraham from Haran in chapter 12 of Genesis. He called him and was like, say, go to this land. Hallelujah. And that is when Abraham started to see those changes. His life was transformed. His life was changed forever because he went to a place where the Lord called him. Same applied with Joseph. When Joseph was called, it's not like he saw a dream and he became a ruler, or his brothers, they bowed down to him while they were still staying together. But Joseph had to be transported to Egypt in the hardest way possible. He was sold, he was put in prison, but that was his way of him going to a destined place. In fact, Egypt was Joseph's promised land. You have your promised land, and to get there, it might not be easy. You don't know how you're gonna get there. Some people, they get there with ease. They just travel and things begin to happen, amazing things into that new place. But some, they go through struggles which they have to conquer. Allow me to tell you, just like the Israelites, they had to go through the wilderness in which the Lord had to test them. They had to go through a lot, but they've been murmuring, complaining, all those things. And most of them, it ended up costing them. It took them 40 years to finally get to Canaan. And along the way, most of them, they died because of being rebellious before the Lord, because of their unbelief. Along the way, things were hard. The journey was not easy. So they got tempted. But when you conquer, when you overcome, you know, after this, I am guaranteed to witness this. I am guaranteed to enjoy. I am guaranteed for a major breakthrough. Hallelujah. The Lord does not allow us to live in the wilderness for the rest of our lives. That's not how the plans for He has for us. But the plans that He has for you is to live in Canaan. But before you can handle the things of Canaan, remember, even when the Lord was reminding them that do not adopt the ways of those people, but stick to me. Remember my word. Remember to keep my law. Remember to worship me. When now you are relaxed, now you are full. You knew that a time will come where now they have everything. They have eaten. Now they feel like life is so. It's like that, you know, when you no longer have trials, when you no longer have challenges, you tend to even forget, to be tempted to even backslide and do and the rest. So the Lord, they had to remind them, do not forget about me. But before you could get to Canaan, the best way for them to be shaped, to handle it, to handle the riches and all, is if they would survive the wilderness, remain obedient. It was necessary so that we could be able to handle those blessings. Allow me to tell you, most of the people today, and even yourself, you might have felt this, that, you know what, why can't the Lord just bless me? Why do I have to go through all this? Why do I have to be tested? I already believe in God. I already know that God is God. I already know that I will never forsake the Lord. But allow me to tell you that it's because of what you are feeling right now. But in reality, most people, they have felt like that. But the moment the Lord started blessing them, they had backslidden. They had forgotten about the Lord. They have forgotten that He exists. They have, you know, like all those things. So you need to overcome. It's necessary. You might feel like there is no need at the moment. I remember also during my studies, at times we would ask ourselves, like, why do we have to study mathematics? We don't see a need. if maybe I'm to study medicine, will I be writing medicine when it comes to treating somebody when they are sick? Why do we have to, what's the need for meds? You get what I'm saying? But it was only recently, after having grown up, I began to see the value and the reason why I had to study mathematics and all those other subjects. In fact, education as a whole, I realized, well, as I was comparing the people who never went to school and those who went to school, I began to realize that those people, they differ. Someone has not gone to school, even their reasoning can't be compared with somebody else's who had gone to school. So when I began to see the value and the necessity of studying, I was like, okay, studying helps to open up your mind. When you are solving those equations in mathematics, you are opening up your mind, you are learning to reason out and all those things, just like video games. Now I understand why people who play games, their mind is sharp. Even a kid, if they can play games, they can just rather fail just because they don't study. But those people, they can think, because games have puzzles, games have a lot of things. You have to reason, you have to think until you conquer a level, and as a result your mind is being trained to think outside the box. So that's the same thing even when it comes to your promised land, God's training. You have to go through the wilderness. After conquering the wilderness, you can handle Canaan. Those people, the Israelites, they felt like they were ready. They were like, why did you have to come here and die in the wilderness? They did not know that their complaints is a sign that they are not yet ready to handle the Canaan. When today you are being impatient, you are busy complaining, why can't the Lord bless me? It's a sign that yet you are not ready to handle Canaan. You're supposed to get to a place where you are peaceful, you are patient, you are waiting for the Lord's perfect timing for him to bless you and give you what you want. And that's where now you can handle your promised land. And allow me to tell you that somebody is closer to getting to a promised land. You're about to get to a promised land. Just hang in there just a little longer. You will get there. Do not fail the Lord before you arrive there. Do not be one who will be destroyed by the Lord like those Israelites before you get to Canaan. Okay? Be destroyed. He will not destroy you by killing you, but I'm saying sometimes he will no longer give you those blessings because you can't handle them. Sometimes receiving those blessings when you're not ready, those blessings will only destroy you. So the Lord, at times, he won't risk blessing you with that blessing when you are not ready, because it won't help a thing, but it will just make matters worse. So you're about to get there, and you must understand what the promised land has for you, and you must understand where you are getting into. So that was the function of today's message. Receive it. May you get to your promised land. May you be happy. May you begin to rejoice. Praise the Lord in the name of Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. And just remember to check our brand new channel, The Gospel with Ishmael. The link is on the description of the video below. You'll really enjoy it. Okay, check it out right now. As well as, if you enjoyed today's video, like it, share it, subscribe, and hit the notification bell so you know every time I upload new videos like this. And remember to be a born-again Christian, surrender your life unto Lord Jesus Christ. If you had backslidden or no longer sure of your salvation, rededicate your life unto the Lord Jesus Christ, re-invite him back into your heart, and ask the Holy Spirit to come, guide, and lead you. And for testimonies, prayer requests, and spiritual advices, DM me on my Instagram or email me. The details are on the description of the video below. And as for me, Ishmael, and your priest, I will see you in the next video upload. Take care and stay blessed.